Hello, and welcome to your technique video for the Molecular Weight by Freezing Point Depression Lab. In this video, you will learn how to measure the freezing point of a pure solvent and of a solution. In exercise 1, you will be observing the freezing point of pure benzophenone. You will need a hot water bath at a later point in the procedure, so before starting, put a beaker of water on a hot plate and let it begin heating so that it will be ready when you need it. You will begin by weighing out about 5 to 7 grams of the benzophenone. Record the mass in your notebook. Use the weighing paper to transfer the benzophenone to a test tube. Place a thermometer and a wire stirrer inside the test tube, and then place the test tube in your hot water bath. Watch the contents of the test tube. The crystals will begin to melt as the temperature rises. You can use the wire stirrer to help mix everything up so that it melts completely. Once the solvent is clear and colorless and you cannot see any remaining crystals, you can remove it from the hot water bath and place it in an empty beaker. We will use two different observations to determine the freezing point. The first will be the temperature when you see the first crystals form, and the second is to observe when the temperature is the same for 2 or 3 successive readings. If you look at the heating curve here, you can see that as the solid is melting, the temperature remains constant at the freezing point. To get the successive readings, you will carefully watch the thermometer and record the temperature every 3 seconds. Compare your observed freezing point to the value given in your laboratory manual. If it is very different, your solid might be contaminated and you should get another sample of benzophenone from a different bottle and let your TA know about your results. If your freezing point is close to the accepted value, continue to exercise 2. Select a vial of unknown solid and record the number on the bottle. Measure out about 0.5 grams of the unknown and transfer the solid to the test tube containing the benzophenone. You will repeat the same procedure as before. Place the test tube in the hot water bath. Allow the crystals to melt. When you no longer see any crystals and the solution is clear and colorless, remove the test tube and place it in the beaker. Record the temperature every 3 seconds as you did for the pure solvent. When you see the first crystal form, record the temperature in your data table. Record the temperature 2 or 3 more times and see if it remains constant. You will repeat this heating cooling process for a total of at least 3 trials. At the end of the lab, you will melt the benzophenone solution once more and then go to the benzophenone wash bottle and pour as much as you can into the waste bottle. Use small volumes of acetone to wash the test tube, thermometer, and the wire stirrer. The acetone wash should be disposed of in the acetone wash bottle. Thank you for watching this video, and I will see you next week.